Why would you not let me read this? Ask him. Ask him, why would you not let me read this?
You accused the Shia earlier, saying that in our books, there are hadith to say about Tahrif al-Quran. Right? Now, when I brought you hadith from your books, saying your Quran is muharraf, you rejected it, correct?
Wait.
You rejected it.
Wait.
And I'm telling
you. Wait, can you calm down? I'm going to read this anyway. Even if you make noise for half an hour, I will read it.
Honestly, I'm making a point.
Okay. No, you're not making my point. I will read one sentence. You don't want me to read it. One sentence.
By the way, there's hadith. In your Bukhari, this is Bukhari this time. Aisha narrated.
Wait.
She had verses of Quran.
Can you wait?
Written on a piece of...
What happened to you?
And then the Dajjal. A dajjin
what happened
like
to you, man?
A god. What, came okay. and ate
what,
it.
What's wrong with
what
you?
What happened to
what's
our wrong, Quran?
Can you stop? Can you
we
stop?
We have verses of Quran in the stomach of a god.
Can you stop?
Right.
Can you stop?
No.
Can you stop for a second? Can you stop for a second? Can you stop for a second? I'm going to read a definition
Umar
of the Quran.
Said there was a verse of rajim.
Can you stop for a second?
Talk about tahrif. Umar said in Bukhari.
Can you stop for a second?
There were verses about rajim. What is it?
Can you stop for a second?
Nasikh. How could you nasikh rajim? Nasikh or mansukh.
What's happened to you?
What's happened? Your Quran is muharraf right from the source.
Okay, fine, fine.
Do you accept
can,
this?
Can
no,
we?
No.
Can
do you accept this
listen,
hadith?
Listen. What's your name? What's your name?
I do not accept.
What's your name? What's your name?
Abu Karrar.
Abu Karrar. Uh-huh. Abu Karrar. Wait. Uh-huh. Abu Karrar. Right. As soon as I start reading the definition of the Quran, you go on a horse and you're not coming off. Wait. Can you come off the horse?
You
let me read. Let me read.
You can accuse the Shia of tahrif al-Quran.
Let me read the definition of the
Quran.
خلش وخلش وخلش لا كل بصلب الموضوع. And the subject.
And when I brought
yes.
you hadith.
Yes. Because if we are discussing a topic, it's a basic rule. It's a basic rule of any discussion. We are discussing a topic. We need to define the terminology of the topic. Yes? Yes? So that we understand what the topic is. Right? So we are discussing Tahrif al-Quran.
Yes.
Yes?
Yes.
Now we need to define two words. Al-Quran and Al-Tahrif. Okay? So this is the definition of the Quran. This is what I'm trying to do for the past 10 minutes and the brother is not letting me do it. Okay? So now,
from who?
Imam Zarkashi. Imam Zarkashi, is this you can tell me whether you agree or disagree. Al-Quran huwa kalamullah al-mu'jaz. المنزل إلى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم بواسطة جبرائيل عليه السلام وهو المنقول بالتواتر وهو المنقول بالتواتر المكتوب في المصحف What's this?
Shall I read it
for me?
والمتعبد بتلاوته المبدوء بسورة الفاتحة والمختوم بسورة الناس okay
yeah.
do you agree with this
yeah, yeah. okay,
okay?
Yeah.
let me translate it for those who don't know al quran quran is the word of allah which is a miracle al mu'jaz al munazzal ila muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam which was revealed upon rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam bi wasitati jibril alaihi salam by the bi wasita bi wasita
where is sallallahu alaihi wasallam
sallallahu alaihi wasallam صلى الله عليه وسلم
الى
محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم yes
he is not a Shia
okay so why did
yeah,
he have to
say
wait like yes yes okay
See?
Wait
that's one point
I said Imam Zarkashi God gave you the name
Zarkashi when he talk he say صلى الله عليه واله never say صلى الله عليه وسلم
المتعبد okay wait by the wasita of Jibril alayhi salam وهو المنقول بالتواتر and it has been put down by tawatur. Tawatur is continuous reporting, okay? Uninterrupted continuous reporting, okay? By multiple sources. Al-maktub fil-mushaf, which has been written in the mushaf, al-muta'abbad bitilawatihi, and it is used for worship to by reading, right? Al-mabdu, which starts with bisurat al-fatiha, and wal-makhtum bisurat al-nas, okay? And it ends with surat al-nas, right? Okay, do you agree with this definition?
Yes.
Yes? You agree with this definition?
Yeah, I agree with this.
Now, tahrif.
Yes.
Number two, uh-huh. What is the definition of tahrif?
Yes, you tell me.
Tahrif uh-huh. is anything that happened after this definition. Do you agree?
After Quran.
After this definition. Anything after this definition is a tahrif. Make it easy for you and me. Yes? Agreed?
What do you mean by after this? After what?
Have you agreed with this definition with me? You said
yes.
Yes? Yes. Anything other than this definition, anything that doesn't fit into this definition yeah. is tahreef of the Quran.
Yeah.
Yes?
Yes?
Okay. Now, let's talk about tahreef.
Yes.
No, no. Now let's talk about it.
Okay.
All the claims you will make. All the claims. All the claims.
Wait.
Calm down. Now we're getting somewhere. So why do we say the Shia believe in tahreef of the Quran? Why? Because they say Ashab al-Rasul changed the Quran without the authority of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, without his knowledge. Okay, and they removed the names of the Ahlul Bayt and those who were condemned. Okay, these are reports in the Shia books.
Okay,
okay.
And yeah.
This is why we believe this is tahreef.
Wait, now.
With regards to Nasikh and Mansukh, okay, where Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said certain verses will not be put in the Mus'haf. Okay, Ayatul Rajm is one of them. Okay.
No, the prophet didn't say that.
You can reject it. We believe he did. We believe he did.
On what?
We believe because of the change.
Omar has been repeated.
Not
it's Omar. The prophet.
Who is Omar to tell us what the
Omar
Quran is?
Omar said that the only person who heard about Ayatul Rajm is Omar.
Okay. So. What? So Omar is trustworthy to us.
What?
Omar is trustworthy to us. We believe Omar is true.
Wait. So the Jibreel went to Omar. Khalina Achi.
Even if what?
Jibreel. Went to Omar and revealed the Ayatul Rajm for him.
No.
So why didn't the Prophet say it?
Omar is saying.
Why did not the Prophet say Ayatul Rajm?
Why is your blood pressure so high?
No, calm down.
No, you're not calm.
Honestly, I'm calm.
Calm down.
I'm calm. You know, don't calm honestly. Down. I'm so calm inside.
Wait. You accept Omar's version, removing a verse
that Jibreel came to
Allah
and told him about Ayatul Rajm. Subhanallah.
Where is the Quran?
Did Ali agree with the current Quran?
Yes.
Yes. Yes. So the point you're making is false.
Why?
Because Ali has already agreed with
the Quran, not
okay.
with Omar.
Okay. Do you believe in Rajam? Do you believe in Rajam?
Yes.
Yes. Why? It's not in the Quran.
It's not in the Quran. There was never.
The Quran says the punishment is imprisonment.
No, I tell you.
Yeah.
So you don't know what you're talking about. No, I know exactly what I'm talking about.
What are you talking about?
First of all,
calm down.
What's the regime?
First, calm down.
Okay, answer me. Ya akhi, kulma ask you, calm down. Why are you scared?
I am calm.
Why are you scared?
I'm not scared, but you don't.
Did the prophet?
You're shouting and giving me a headache.
Okay.
You're shouting.
Did the prophet recite Ayatul Rajm?
Yes.
Astaghfirullah.
Why astaghfirullah?
The prophet recited Ayatul Rajm?
Yes.
Where is it? Honestly, the first time I hear someone say there was Ayatul Rajm that the prophet recited. Where?
You can ask the question, let him answer.
Where?
How did Omar know that there was Ayatul Rajm?
Omar is not trustworthy.
And when did Omar make this statement?
No. Wait.
When did Omar make this statement?
Listen to me.
When they
in where? In the masjid?
No.
In the masjid?
Wait. Wait.
He said, if I have two witnesses, I will put this and include the Quran. الشيخ والشيخة فرجموهما البتة كنا نقرأها في زمن الرسول.
عمر never said that.
Adnan. Never said that.
Yeah, find it.
Okay.
Bring it to me.
Adnan.
You're gonna show me now. Omar said this, and if it's not true, then
Adnan,
can
you know,
do with these brothers, man?
If you narrate about the Prophet false things. There is hadith, he says, reserve your
I believe
in the lowest of pit of hell.
Okay.
So
are you,
don't
are
say
you listening?
Don't
are, you
say
listen, are you listening to me?
Okay, I'm listening very carefully.
Omar said, are you listening? Listen to me.
I ask you, did
listen
the prophet
to me,
recite
Sheikh, Abu Karrar, listen
the
to me.
Ayah of Rajim,
Abu Karrar,
yes.
Abu Karrar, listen to me. Omar said this verse was in the Quran. Yes?
Was in the Quran.
Yes. Yes or no? I believe Omar is right.
Right.
It was there. I believe it. Now, what? You're going to kill me for that? You're
going to
kill me for believing it?
Yes.
On what basis?
On what basis?
On the conditions of the Shaykhain, Shaykh Bukhari, the Mustadrak, it's in Musnad Ahmad, Tabaqat ibn Sa'd.
It's in Bukhari.
It's in Sunnah.
This report about Omar, Omar is in Bukhari. That people will say afterwards, it's in Bukhari. It's in Bukhari, my friend, you're wasting your breath.
It's also in Bukhari, yes. So Omar,
you only take Bukhari.
Reveals verses of Quran.
We take all the authentic sources.
So Omar reveals verses of Quran that the Prophet did not know about.
No.
That's what you're saying.
I'm saying Omar cannot possibly attribute something false to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and still remain Amir al-Mu'mineen.
On what basis?
Because he was Amir al-Mu'mineen. Everyone, all the Sahaba, including Ali, except Ali gave his daughter to him. If Umar was a liar, had to be recognized to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. First of all,
you're trying to tell me everyone narrates something.
Abu Qarar, are we having a discussion?
Okay. We are.
Umar, first of all, do you accept that Umar said that? Two witnesses. Do you know what I'm asking for? You said Umar said two witnesses, and then I will.
No, because there is many of it.
No. Yeah, I know which one.
Adnan, you are saying
that's Abu Bakr, right? And that's in Fathul Bari. You say. By the way, I'm telling you where it is.
You're saying that Umar, being the only one who heard about the verse of Rajim, right? Listen to me. This is serious. I don't know how you believe this, honestly. Saying that the Prophet also said it.
You're not scoring any points against me.
I'm not saying that. How could you believe this?
Any more dramatic.
I am saying to you,
yes. Do you accept that Umar said it?
Umar said it, yes.
Did Ali know that Umar said it?
No, listen.
Did Ali know that Umar said it?
So what? Umar says, what do you think? Wait.
Yes. Now, because I am coming from an angle, it's gonna, you know, chain ball, a chain ball.
Yes, yes.
You know, you don't hear it coming.
Yes.
You see when it hits you.
Imam Ali never approved of this.
Whatever Umar is, whatever he was, you know, whatever you claim he was, I'm asking a question.
Yes.
You believe Ali is the most knowledgeable person after the Prophet alive?
Yes.
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 Agreed.
Yes.
Halas.
Yes.
So Ali. He even knows, according to you, Ilmul Ghaib. Yes?
Why is it?
Yes? Some of it. Okay. Now we're talking. Okay. Did Ali know that Umar said this?
The Salafis. No. I'll tell you what.
Answer my question.
Whenever they are cornered, they switch to Imam Ali. I don't know why. Guys, what is Imam Ali?
Because we love Ali bin Abi Talib. We love him truly. But you love him selectively. You love him partially. You follow Ali bin Abi Talib partially.
We were talking about Tahrif al-Quran.
I'm coming to it. I'm going to prove you wrong by your own standards. That's the point I'm raising. That's why I'm raising Ali bin Abi Talib. Point. Did Ali bin Abi Talib know that Umar made this statement?
No,
you're doing the same thing you did in Ibn Taymiyyah discussion. I kept asking you to translate the sentence.
Okay. The Quran we have.
Abu Qarar.
That's the Quran we have has Ayatul Rajim.
Abu Qarar.
That's the Quran we have. Answer me. That's the Quran we have.
Who is he?
You like him?
Muhammad Hassan. I like him. Why? What's it?
He said what I'm saying.
What did he say?
Al-Shaykh wa Shaykh Farjumuhum al-Batta.
Yeah.
He said, if not the people, they say, Umar, write it down, I will put it in my hand in the Quran.
Umar never made that statement.
He had.
So, okay, he's saying it. Find it. Send me the... Anyway,
okay.
Ali bin Abi Talib, did he know that Umar made that statement? Yes or no? You're not answering my question.
Did the Prophet recite Ayatul Rajim?
I'm asking a question.
No, answer me this.
Do you accept?
No, okay, leave Imam Ali aside. Let's go to the main one.
Yes, I believe he did.
Where? Give me evidence.
Umar said it.
Umar said
that the Prophet ﷺ.
No, he didn't say
that. We used to read this in the Quran.
Never said Umar. Umar never said in the hadith his hadith that he heard it from the Prophet. Never. Give me.
So what does that mean? We used to read it. We have already agreed with the Quran, is right?
Yes.
Al-Munazzil. Ila Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yes, we agreed.
Yes.
So Umar is saying this used to be in the Quran. Yes. We used to read it in the Quran.
Where is it?
Okay. Yes, in the same very report. The report you're using.
Not be in the Quran?
Yes, Ayatul Rajm. Ayatul Rajm.
Not be in the Quran then. Ayatul Rajm.
Do you know the Quran has Nasikh and Mansukh? Do you know about it?
Okay.
Yes. Do you believe in? Okay. Do you believe in Nasikh?
I believe in Nasikh. Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
So this was one of the Mansukh verses.
No. What kind? There are three types of Nasikh.
Okay. What is it?
Three types of Nasikh.
Which
Mansukh.
One? Yeah. Tell me which one.
Right. Yeah. One of them is Tahrif. The one you're talking about is Tahrif.
No.
The very thing you're talking about is Tahrif.
No.
There is not Nasikh. There is nothing.
You see, what does the Hadith say? The Prophet, when the scribe, when he was asked, shall we put this verse in the Mus'haf? And the Prophet said, no.
The Prophet never said that.
No.
Umar says, if people If people don't accuse me of tahrif al-Quran,
now you wait.
I would have forced it in the Quran.
You wait. Right? Ayatul Rajam. Ayatul Rajam is very simple. Okay. Ayatul Rajam. All your points you make are lame, and they can be countered in 1 second. Okay. If you remain calm and have a discussion. Here. All the reports will come up. Al-Mansukha wa Aya Surah An-Nur. Okay? Yeah, reports are here.
What?
I don't know why you take 1 hour to find them. I take them in 1 second.
Okay, please read the hadith.
Okay. Read it and you translate it. An Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu an qala inna Allah ba'atha Muhammadan sallallahu alayhi wa sallam bil haqq wa anzala alayhi al-kitab fa kana mimma anzala Allah ayatul rajm fa qara'naha wa akalnaha wa wa'aynaha. What does that mean?
Carry on.
Translate.
Carry on.
No.
That's what
he said.
No, I will. What he's saying.
No, translate that.
That is what he's saying.
Okay. That is, okay. What does that mean? وَقَرَأْنَاهَا.
Yes.
وَعَقَلْنَاهَا. وَعَيْنَاهَا.
That's what, okay. Carry on.
Okay. رَجَمَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ وَرَجَمْنَا. He used to. بَعْدَهُ فَأَخْشَ إِنْ طَالَ بِالنَّاسِ زَمَانٌ أَنْ يَقُولَ قَائِلٌ وَاللَّهِ مَا نَجِدُ آيَةَ الرَّجَمْ. في كتاب الله فيدل بترك فريدة أنزلها الله والرجم في كتاب الله الحق حق على ما زنى إلى أحسن من الرجال والنساء إذا قامت البينة أو كان الحبل أو الاعتراف.
Okay, carry on.
So that's it, finished. No. So here, what do we get? It's in Bukhari and Muslim.
Yes.
We believe. Umar is saying, yes, that we used to read it in the Quran.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. And we had, taken it in. Yeah. For example, we had memorized it.
Yeah.
Okay. But now, okay, it is not there. And some people can say that we will not do Rajam, okay, because the verse is not in the Quran. Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Now, it's in Bukhari and Muslim.
Yes.
Okay. So you're not bringing something new. It's like, when you try to score points against us,
I'm not scoring
bringing these things as if we don't know them. We do know them, and we believe them, that the verse was revealed, and then it was mansukh. Okay, it was mansukh. It was Rasulullah by the permission of Rasulullah, by his own. What we call the word for that is there is a word, tawqif. By the tawqif of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Okay. Tawqif. Yes.
So do tawqif only for the writing of the verse or the hukum as well?
Tawqif is writing, hukum, everything.
Exactly.
And the order and the tartib. And the tartib of the Quran is tawqif.
Yeah.
Why is tawqif?
Yes.
First of all, do you accept?
No, I don't accept this. This is tahrif. What you're saying is that the Prophet removed the verse, the actual wording of the verse.
Yes.
And he kept the execution of it, the hukum.
Yes. Because we have mansukh al-tilawa.
Okay.
Okay, wait. We have two types of we have two types of nasakh. Yeah. Okay? Mansukh al-tilawa and mansukh al-hukm.
Yes.
Okay?
Yes.
There are verses in the Quran, there are mansukh al-hukm. Do you agree?
Yes.
Okay?
Mansukh,
yes.
Mansukh al-hukm, but not mansukh al-tilawa.
Why? Why?
Because you have a verse.
Why?
Right? Yeah. You have one verse. Mm-hmm. And then Allah later bring another verse to do nasakh to the existing verse.
Yes.
Both of them, they still in the Quran.
Yes, fine.
Are you following me?
Yes, I am following you.
Good.
Yes.
Good.
Yes.
So there's no tahrif in
this. So when... No. Wait.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
I am saying, you do not follow Umar. To you, Umar was Dajjal, Kafir.
Wait.
I follow Umar. Okay, wait. You know. Right. I believe this verse was revealed. We believe in the concept of mansukh al-tilawa and mansukh al-hukam. We believe in that. Okay, we believe in that. I'm telling you, we believe in that based upon our sources. We are consistent with our sources.
When you say mansukh
al-tilawa, you are rejecting. You are rejecting it.
No, you
are. I'll tell you why you wait.
That's
okay, I'm gonna have to stop talking to you. Okay, let's have a discussion.
You're moving.
Let's have a discussion. No. No, it's not tahrif. It's not tahrif. It's nasakh. It's nasakh which the Prophet himself did. You are now not willing to accept.
Wait.
Listen, if I cannot stop, if it cannot finish.
Carry on.
Yeah. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave us two types of nasakh. One is mansukh al-tilawa.
Yes.
I believe this because of my sources.
Yes.
Okay? This is what our sources are telling us.
Okay.
We are 100% sure, we are absolutely certain that our sources are authentic. Our sources are not a bunch of a pack of lies like yours are. We believe the Shia sources.
Okay?
So we believe in that. We are consistent with our sources. We have a very consistent view that after the death of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Quran, no one can add or no one can take away anything, even a dot. All of this, what we're discussing right now, the verses about Rida, verses about Rajum.
Where are they?
Okay.
Where are they?
Are we having a discussion?
Yeah, we are.
Listen to me first.
Yes.
We're all dealt with by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It was the Prophet who decided what happens to them. Okay, because he, who is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Ma yantiqu anil hawa in huwa illa wahyun yuha.
If he actually said them.
Wait.
If he actually said them.
Okay. Right. So you believe he didn't say them.
No.
We believe he did.
No,
he did. Now the issue is the now the issue is
yeah.
I'm saying anything after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away.
Yeah.
After he died. The Quran we have today in tartib
according to you
was already
muharram.
In
tartib. Yeah.
In its length,
yes.
In its width, in its wording, is from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because he read the Quran in the current form to his companions.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
What you are claiming, what your sources claim, is that after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away, Ashabul Rasul, they changed the Quran, they removed the names of the Ahlul Bayt. Even some of your scholars claim the names of the 12 Imams were there. They were removed by the Sahaba.
Okay.
Wait, brothers, wait, let me finish. Yes.
They removed
the names and all. So what you are calling tahrif is tawqif. The word for that is tawqif of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What you are to support your notion of tahrif, your idea of tahrif, your changing of the Quran after the Prophet died, you go back to the Sahaba.
No.
What you do is you go back in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
No.
You say no. Look. All of this. Look what Umar is saying. Look what Aisha is saying about Rida. And look
what are you saying? We have 12 Imam. If they are agree, we are agree. If they are not,
you don't have them.
You don't have them.
You don't have the 12 Imam.
You only
have two. And even those two curse the people who were narrating.
Have you finished?
Yeah.
Can I talk now without interruption?
Yeah.
Okay, because I listen to you. Right. First of all, for everyone to know that the Shia do not believe in Tahrif al-Quran. I told him earlier, the book he has in his house, it's the same as mine in my house.
No, really.
Let him finish. Let him finish. He made a very.
Listen. Let me.
Wait.
No.
Go and read. Can I find the verse? Find the verse.
Listen. Adnan. Okay. Surah Al-Kahf. First, this is not my first point.
The word Salih is not. He's saying.
Omar, can you discuss this with the brother over there? Please, because you're interrupting me. Right.
It's a big claim you're making.
Adnan. This is to start with. But because you started accusing us in believing tahrif of al-Quran, I brought you verses to show in your books that are authentic, you said, which makes it worse.
No.
Because at least,
no.
Listen, let me finish. At least I could say our hadith in our book da'if. I reject any hadith that says our book is muharraf, alhamdulillah. Because our books, according to you, they are da'if. But you said your books are authentic.
Yes.
So any hadith that says or indicate that your Quran is muharraf, you have to accept it. You cannot reject it. You understand?
I agree.
Okay.
If it's muharraf, yes, I agree.
Yeah, okay,
we have to accept if it's tahrif. And what is tahrif?
You accept the tahrif.
If some,
you don't reject it.
No, no. If an authentic report tells me that there is tahrif in the Quran, yeah, I'll accept it.
What?
I'll accept the report.
That the Quran is muharraf.
Yes. And what is tahrif? What is tahrif? Okay. Anything that happened after the Prophet. Yes?
Okay.
Yes?
Okay, fine.
Yes?
Fine.
Anything that happened after the Prophet is tahrif. Hello, hello, hello. What is
what are you talking about?
Why did I read the definition?
We just agreed. Let me finish.
Why did I read the definition?
We just agreed on your definition. You brought me a definition of the Quran.
Yes.
And we all agreed on.
And what is that?
Right. That the Quran, that as we have it here, is by tawatur, not muharraf.
Okay.
But you just said, no, if the hadith comes in my book,
it's not,
which is true, and says it is muharraf,
listen,
I'll accept it.
Abu Qarar, wait.
You're contradicting yourself.
Okay, well, no, you're confusing things. I said anything after the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam,
is tahrif.
Okay, wait, are you listening? Anyone who claims changes in the Quran after the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, has passed away, that is tahrif.
Yes.
Anything the Prophet himself did with the Quran, his editing of the Quran, his placing of the verses in certain surahs, is tawqif.
Yes.
Listen. Understand the concept so that we can save time.
I understand very well.
Yeah. Anything the Prophet did in our sources, whether Umar tells us, whether Abu Huraira tells us, or Aisha tells us, the people you love the most, any one of them, whoever tells us that the Prophet did this, we believe it. It is not tahrif. After the Prophet has read the Quran to Zayd bin Thabit in the final year twice, and in the current tartib, anything after that is tahrif. Or anyone who claims that this tartib is not from the Prophet, or it is not mutawatir, or there are things taken out of this current Quran that were not known to the Prophet, things without his permission, that's tahrif. And this is what the Shias believe in.
Okay.
When you said the Shias do not believe in tahrif, you are lying. Let me give you a name.
Let me give you a name. Let me give you a name.
You just lied in front of all of us. The Shias do not believe in the tahrif. You are lying. Either you don't know or you're lying. Which one is it?
He's saying that.
You'd rather
accept the tahrif in Quran in your books if hadith has said so.
Okay, I'm going to say the name of a book now. Okay. And I'll see if you know the...
No, wait a second.
You said the Shias do not believe in tahrif.
He believes...
What did I tell you about the tahrif?
Let me finish my point, please. You talk to him later. Right. He believes there is hukum called rajm.
Wait.
Let me finish.
Wait, Abu Qarar. Abu Qarar. No, no.
There is hukum.
Abu Qarar.
Rajm.
Abu Qarar.
And there is hukum rida'at al-kabir, the breastfeeding of the adult. Now we say to him, where did you get that from? He said, from Quran. And he said, I want to ask him, where are the verses? He says, disappeared.
When did I say, and you said earlier,
the Quran came to us by tawatur.
Yes.
So you applying a hukum to me that does not exist in the Quran? What is this?
Can I respond?
No, what is this?
Yes, I'm telling you what is this.
How is that possible?
I'm telling you what is this. Again, I will repeat myself.
That is tahrif.
I will repeat myself.
Tahrif.
The Quran, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam read to Zayd bin Thabit in the last year of his life, twice.
Yes.
In the current tartib we have today, is transmitted by tawatur. And amazingly, there's not one Shia in any of the 10 Qira'at. Not one. Hafs is not Shia. Hafs is not Shia.
What do you think of
He's a good, great man. He's narrated the Quran.
You know what Albani said about him?
Yeah.
كان يضع الحديث he's a fabricated hadith about
show me 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 no show me where Albani said what he said and we know Hafs is daif in hadith we know that I know
so how do you accept him for Quran
okay
the guy said he's a liar
I'll answer your question now you know Abu Hanifa who is Imam Abu Hanifa wait one second who is Imam Abu Hanifa who is
No.
Who is Imam Abu Hanifa? Who is Imam Abu Hanifa? Yeah, no, of course he's not. He's daif al hadith. I know. Hafs is daif al hadith. But what does to you guys, daif al hadith means a liar, because you don't know. You're jahil about our science of hadith. I'm telling you now. Do you know Abu Hanifa? Who is Abu Hanifa? Who's Abu Hanifa?
Who is he?
He's one of the four imams. He is the father of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah. All four schools are unanimous that he was the first man to come and his school is the first school. Okay, okay. No, no. You know he's Da'if al-Hadith. Did you know that? Now, is he a liar? Is he a liar? Imam.